गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट हाउ टू कैलकुलेट क्यू वैल्यू ऑफ एनर्जी एंड व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ व्हाट इज द न्यूक्लियर रिएक्शन एंड हाउ कैन वी कैलकुलेट द क्यू वैल्यू ऑफ द न्यूक्लियर एनर्जी और न्यूक्लियर रिएक्शन. ओके, इन दिस क्लास we discuss a very important thing, that is nuclear fission and nuclear fusion. Okay, so before going to nuclear fission and fusion, as we know, in the process of radioactivity we generally found a highly unstable nucleus like uranium, polonium, actinium, radium. They emit the radiation continuously. Okay, that means they are generally unstable in nature because of presence of large amount of protons inside the nucleus, and because of this, those materials always possess radioactivity. Okay, and another thing also we discuss, we can make bombard any particle, that is projectile, to any nucleus to form out a nuclear reaction. Okay, and there is also a possibility that we can combine two or more nucleus to form a large nucleus. Okay, so there are a number of things that will arise inside nuclear fission and fusion. Okay, so first we discuss about nuclear fission. Okay, so nuclear fission means we can say it is generally nuclear process in which a highly unstable or heavy nucleus, when undergoes a process of radioactive or undergo disintegration, it emits some radiations or some outgoing particles along with the new nucleus or new elements. Okay, that means we can say the reaction or the phenomenon in which a heavy nucleus, generally it can take a heavy nucleus having mass number greater than 200. Okay, so it is a process or phenomenon in which a heavy nucleus undergoes disintegration to form two or more smaller nuclei. Okay, and in such process there is also some emission of external energies. Okay, and we can calculate this energy that evolve in a nuclear reaction. Okay, a nuclear reaction generally takes place when a heavy nucleus undergoes disintegration in order to form two or more smaller nuclei. Okay, a heavy nucleus, suppose we can take an example to discuss the new process of nuclear fission. Okay, suppose we take a small example of uranium nucleus. Okay, generally uranium possesses large number of protons, that means we can say generally uranium has 92 protons inside the nucleus. Okay, so if we bombard a uranium nucleus by a projectile like neutron. Okay, neutron is being neutral and it has a high penetration power. Okay, so when a neutron is projected on a uranium nucleus, what we find, the uranium undergoes to excited state, that means the energy of the uranium nucleus gradually increases. Okay, so when a neutron makes collision with a uranium nucleus, we find excited state of uranium nucleus, okay, and in that excited state the uranium splits to give two smaller nuclei like baryon and krypton. Okay, suppose we take baryon, that is 56 141, and krypton, that is 36 92, along with emission of some neutral 3 neutrons, okay, plus some extra energies. Okay, so when a heavy nucleus like uranium undergoes disintegration because of collision with a neutron, then a uranium nucleus breaks into two different nuclei like baryon and krypton. Okay, and in this process there is also emission of 3 neutrons, that means they can cause more nuclear reaction. Okay, so what we find here, we find a heavy nucleus breaks to give two or more smaller nuclei, okay, and that process is known as nuclear fission. Okay, understand? So in case of nuclear fission, we can calculate the Q value of the energy or Q value of that nuclear reaction. Okay, so in order to calculate the Q value of the nuclear reaction, as we discussed in previous lecture, that the Q value of the nuclear reaction depends upon initial mass and final mass, that means mass before reaction and mass after reaction. Okay, so in order to calculate the new energy in a nuclear fission, we can take the help of mass of the elements which are taken. Okay, suppose generally in case of a nuclear fission or fission of uranium nucleus, the energy evolved from fission of uranium nucleus is about 200 mega electron volt. Okay, so now calculate how this energy is calculated. Okay, suppose the mass of the different elements in the nuclear reactions are, suppose we given masses are mass of neutron, that is 1.008665. okay, second thing, mass of uranium nucleus. Okay, so that will be mass of uranium, so that is 235.0439 U. okay, second thing, mass of baryon, that will be 56 141, that is around 140.9139 U. okay, and mass of krypton, so that will also 91.8178173. Okay, so these are the different masses given in the nuclear fission process. Okay, so now calculate the Q value of the nuclear reaction. Okay, so now measure initial mass of the reaction, that is the initial mass, that is before reaction the mass projectile is neutron and uranium nucleus. So initial mass equals to 1.008665 U plus 235.0439. So if you calculate, so that will be 236.0525 U. Okay. Second thing, that is final mass, that equals to mass of barium, mass of krypton, and mass of 3 neutrons. Okay. So mass of barium, that is 140.9139 plus 91.8973 plus 3 times mass of neutron 0.8665, and if you add this, that will be 235.8371. Okay, so this is the initial mass, that is mass before reaction, and this is mass after reaction. Okay, so as mass before reaction is greater and mass after reaction is small, then we can say here the energy in such process will be positive. When Q is positive, that means such type of reaction is a exothermic reaction. Okay, so now what will be the Q value? Okay, so there is a change of mass, means we can calculate here mass defect. Okay, so mass defect delta M, that is the change of mass, that is initial mass minus final mass. Okay, so initial mass, that will be 236.0525 minus 235.8371. So if you calculate, so the value will be 0.215 U. Okay, so that will be the change of mass in the nuclear fission of a uranium nucleus. Okay, so now we can calculate the energy. Okay, as per the Einstein mass energy relation, the energy emitted in the nuclear reaction, that is del M into C square. Okay, so that will be also equal to delta M into 931. So here the mass is in atomic mass unit, so directly use the formula delta M into 931 mega electron volt. So that will be 0.215 into 931 MeV. So that will be around 200 mega electron volt. Okay. So because of fission of one uranium nucleus, we find the energy emitted is about 200 mega electron volt. Okay. So in one fission, we can emit 200 mega electron volt of energy. Okay. And generally the nuclear fission process is used in case of a atom bomb. Okay. Inside atom bomb, we fill with a large number of uranium nucleus. And when that large number of uranium nucleus, a small neutron is bombarded, then a one neutron will collides with one of the uranium nucleus. Okay, and that one uranium nucleus, when breaks, it forms baryon and krypton along with 3 neutrons with emission of 200 MeV of energy. Okay, and the emitted 3 neutrons again act as 3 projectile. Okay, that means we can say suppose we take a scheme of such atom bomb formation reaction. Okay, suppose that is one uranium nucleus. Okay, and it is bombarded with a small projectile like neutron. Okay, and when that uranium nucleus breaks, it gives one barium nucleus, one krypton nucleus. Okay, along with 3 emission particles. Okay, and these 3 emission particles, again these are the neutrons. Okay, and these 3 neutrons again collides with the other uranium inside the atom bomb. Okay, these three emitted neutrons again collides with the other uranium nucleus, and when this uranium nucleus again breaks, they form 3 0 and 1, and here that is also 3 0 and 1, and here also 3 0 and 1. Okay, so that means 9 neutrons. Okay, again these 9 neutrons again collides with 9 uranium nucleus, and because of this another, that means we can say there are around 27, and this 27 when collides with 27 uranium nucleus, that means we can say that is a chain reaction type process. Okay, and because of the fission of the uranium nucleus, in each fission we get 200 MeV of energy, and because of this chain reaction we get a large amount of energy. Okay, so in case of nuclear fission process, there always possess a chain reaction inside the atom bomb, and in because of that chain reaction we get extremely large amount of energy. Okay, understand? Okay, now let us discuss about nuclear fusion. Okay, so what do we mean by fusion? Fusion means combination. Okay, that means we can say in a fusion reaction we have to generally combine two or more nucleus to form a heavy nucleus. That means the fusion process always involves the combination of lighter nuclei whose mass number always less than 8. Okay, the elements whose mass number less than or equal to 8, they generally possess nuclear reaction, like nuclear fusion. Okay, so in case of nuclear fusion we have to combine two or more lighter nuclei to form a heavy nucleus. Okay, and that night lighter nuclei generally have the mass number less than 8. Okay, so in case of the nuclear fusion process, when we combine small elements or the nucleus having the light mass, generally there is a repulsive force arises during this combination process. Okay, combination means we can say that is the fusion of one nucleus with another. Generally nucleus is positive charge and another nucleus is also positive. Okay, that means when positive and positive makes combine to each other, they experience a repulsive force. Okay, now a question arises, if there is a repulsive force in between the protons, in between the small nucleus, so how they can combine? Okay, that means we can say always a nuclear fusion reaction takes place with the presence of external energy. Okay, that means they can combine or fuse together because of the high energy or high force. Okay, that means always nuclear fusion process requires energy to carry out the reaction. Okay, that means simply we can define a nuclear fusion is a process in which two or more lighter nuclei combines to form a heavy stable nucleus. Okay, and that process is known as nuclear fusion. Okay, and nuclear fusion always takes place in the or with the help of external energy. Okay, and nuclear fusion process is located inside the sun. Okay, that means we can say inside sun there is always combination of small elements or small nucleus to form a big nucleus. Okay, we can take a small example to understand the nuclear fusion process. Okay, so in case of nuclear fusion, suppose we take combination of four protons. Okay, 4 protons, that is suppose we combine 4 1H1 nucleus, that means 1H1 plus 1H1 plus 1H1 plus 1H1. All protons or all the proton nucleus or these are generally positive in nature. So, in order to combine them, we have to apply some external energy. Okay, so we can calculate that energy that is used in that reaction. Okay, so when 4 protons or 4 nucleus combines, then they form helium nucleus. Okay, with emission of 2 emitting particles like positron. Okay, so they emit positrons. Okay, with the emission of energy. Okay, so in case of the fusion reaction, when we take combination of 4 hydrogen atoms, okay, they combines to give helium nucleus with emission of 2 positrons, okay, and some energy. Okay, so now let us calculate the energy that evolve in that fusion process. Okay, and always remember, in case of fusion process, the energy evolved is very small. Okay, as compared to the nuclear fission process. In case of fission, one uranium nucleus provides 200 mega electron volt of energy. Okay, now let us calculate the energy in that fusion process. Okay, and as we know, mass of hydrogen that equals to 1.007825 U. okay, and mass of helium nucleus, so that will be 4.002603 U. okay, and mass of positron, that is massless. Okay, so here before reaction, initial mass equals to 4 into 1.007825, so that will be 4.0313 U. okay, and after reaction, that is formation of helium nucleus, so in if we subtract, the change of mass will be 4.0313 minus 4.002603, so that will give 0.02, so the value will be 0.02860 U. okay, and the energy Q will be del M into 931 MeV, so that will be around 28.69 MeV. okay, so in case of fusion reaction, there is emission of very small amount of energy as compared to the nuclear fission reaction. Okay, so again I repeat, nuclear fission is a process in which a heavy nucleus breaks to give 2 or more smaller nuclei. Okay, and a nuclear fusion means it is combination of 2 or more smaller nuclei to form a heavy nucleus. Okay, generally nuclear fission reaction takes place in the nuclei having mass number greater than 200. Okay, and nuclear fusion process generally takes place in the elements having mass number less than or equal to 8. Then that means they are lighter nuclei. Okay, another thing, the energy in a fission reaction is very large and energy in a fusion reaction is very small. Okay, and nuclear fission reaction may takes place at ordinary temperature. okay, that means they do not need any temperature to carry out the nuclear fission reaction. But nuclear fusion always takes place high temperature to carry out their nuclear reaction process. Okay, nuclear fusion generally takes at a very high temperature. Okay, another thing, so we can say inside nuclear fission we have to always take a projectile like neutron. Okay, but in case of nuclear fusion we do not need any external particles, and generally we need the combination of protons. Okay, in case of fission we need neutrons, okay, and in case of fusion we need protons. Okay, and a nuclear fission reaction is very quick process. Okay, and nuclear fusion reaction is very slow process, because we have to combine smaller nucleus, and generally they takes very long time to complete a fusion reaction. Okay, another things we can say, in nature the fissionable materials, okay, that means the highly stable or highly unstable nucleus or heavy nucleus generally less available. Okay, but fusionable materials is available very large amount. Okay, there is small availability of nuclear fission elements, and there is large availability of nuclear fusion elements. Okay, nuclear fission is that means we can say atom bomb. We can take an example like atom bomb as nuclear fission process, and nuclear fusion process is located in sun and star like things. Okay, so these are the few comparison of nuclear fusion and nuclear fission. Okay, so I think you all able to understand about nuclear fission and nuclear fusion. Okay, thank you.